Welcome back to Let Us Learn to Lead video series on free open source software designed by M. Srinivasan, Training Associate Mathematics, Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan, Zonal Institute of Education and Training, Mumbai. Self-learning contents in video form on GeoGebra, dynamic mathematics software, is presented at this video series. To view the contents, you may join Google Classroom by using the class codes 73AUMBO. In this video, you will learn designing a worksheet to draw a bar chart or bar graph for a given data. For preparing this video lecture, I used Windows 10 operating system, a licensed version, GeoGebra 5.0, a free open source software, and free open source screen recorder software. Let us start. Let me show you what type of worksheet we will be presenting, bar chart or bar graph. Based on the data given to us, we will explain them what is a bar chart, and we will try to draw it in different colors with the different backgrounds. And we can tell the children that this is a bar graph against the subject and the mark obtained. The bar graph may be any bar can be done and any value can be given. Therefore, a child can come and check out with the different colors that how their bar graph looks like. We will try to design this dynamic worksheet from scratch. For that, I have taken GeoGebra Classic 5 worksheet. Here, as we are going to draw the bar graph, we may not be interested to have this grid, but we will remove the grid. But remember, this is actually 1:1. Therefore, we, based on the given data, we have to manipulate the values on the y-axis with respect to values on the x-axis. Let us see it. For that, let us go to this view and then go to this spreadsheet, because we need the data. Already I have typed the data and keep it ready. You can also type it. I have taken only the marks obtained by a child in 5 different subjects, and I am going to put it in the bar graph. I am coming and copying it here. Now, the first one is subject, second one is marks. For don't take the first row, take only the subjects, the 5 data. Right click it and then go for create and the list. This can be typed by you, but you see, you have to type it with inverted commas and then comma, then inverted, this one again comma, therefore it will take time, but it is a very easy one. But again, go to these marks, right click, select it, create the list. Now 2 lists have been obtained by you. Okay, now your job started now. Now we have to manipulate it, because we have seen from the data given, 88 is the biggest number, therefore from bottom to up to 88, I want it. Therefore, on the y axis, I want the numbers to be multiples of 10. For that, go to this preferences, or here also you can do a right click. This object properties will come. Suppose if you are not getting it, here click it, go to this graphics. Here in the y axis, you have the distance as 10. Tick, click, tick the distance and keep it as 10, then enter. Now it has become 10. On the x-axis, we don't want to show the numbers, or we will not show the numbers now. Okay. Now one more thing we have to make. That is, we have to make the ratio. The ratio is 1:10. We have to make the ratio as 1:10. For in 1, that will be 10. In 2, that will be 20 like that. Okay. Then only the bar graph will come inside this screen. Otherwise, it will go outside. Okay. Now, I think it is perfect now. I think I want only up to 90. Where I can, by moving my mouse in that wheel, where I can make it as 90. Okay, perfect. It is perfect now. Now, I am having a list 1 and list 2. Very simple now. We have to go for bar graph. We can have a heading. Okay. Then we can tell the children that I am going to draw a bar graph. Where we can have a heading. Bar graph or bar chart. Okay, both are one and the same. So that the child can understand that actually what you are doing. Again, you can tell them that what is the meaning of that bar chart. You can discuss with the children. It is a rectangular bars will be there and so on. Okay, well, now keep it at the top. Okay, now we are going to directly draw the bar graph. It is very simple. L1 and L2 has been being defined now. go in the input in the input bar, you type bar, simply it will come bar chart. Take the third one, that is list of data, list of frequencies with the bars. In the list of data, you type L1, tab, go to L2, the second one is L2. Then the width, you can have 0.75 will be the better one. Therefore, I am taking 0.75. You can have 0.5, you can have 0.1 also, but it will become very lengthy, then it is left to you. Okay, then the gap will be there. For example, I will just show you, 0.5 will be very, very small. Sometimes, if you put one here, if you put one here, see, all of them has become a histogram. Therefore, it will be better to have 0.75, so that there will be a gap will be there. Okay, now you can right-click it and then don't ask it to not show the object. It's actually showing some value of it. Therefore, don't show the label. Okay, now you got this chart now. Now, what you have to do is, all of you know that I want all the chart to have different colors. Therefore, select it. Okay, escape and then select it. Go to this object properties. Highly interesting. What you can do is, here, if you go to its style, you are seeing its style, line style can be, you can have line thickness, very good line thickness you can have. But remember, you can change the color or you can change the style of each bar separately. That is highly interesting. How many bars are there? You see, bar 1, bar 2, bar 3, bar 4 and bar 5. Go to this color, okay, then you can have a different color for a different thing if you want. If you want to have a different color, you can have a common color to all, or otherwise you don't want it, then you can leave it, or you can have a separate color for each one separately. That is, it's left to you. Okay, suppose I am going to the object property once again. Now actually the color was, if you don't want the color to be there, then all the bars you can remove it. Then bar 1 you can give a color, bar 2 you can give a color, bar 3 you can give a color, and so on. Okay, now when you go to this style, it is highly interesting. Suppose bar 1, I can have the style, then you can go to the bricks and then you have dots. You see, it is coming in dots. Bar 2, I can have, for example, hatching. Okay, bar 3, I can have weaving. Good. Then bar 4, what I can have? Cross hatching. Okay. Bar 5, it is left to you. Please play around and then check out. Which is highly chessboard. Okay, now it is different. I'm just closing it. Left to you, you can choose the color and so on. Now my next idea is, I want to display the table. I want to display the table. Therefore, go for in the input bar, table text, table text, table text. In the first, you type L1. Okay, tab, it will go to the second one, L2. We don't have anything else, therefore remove the remaining. Okay, then you can have a, you can remove it. Okay, then enter. You see, you got this one also is come for the children to understand better. Now, all of you may be knowing that, sir, I want to put the subjects there in the top. There also, there is one option is there. You can go to the text and then type. The another one is very simple. You can go for, there is one option, element L1, 1. For example, L1, 1. Element L1, 1. If you type it, you see, English automatically has come. It's English has come. Now, I think what you can do, you can go to the object property and you can have the text as very, very small. Very small you can have. Okay. Then you can just keep it over here. Now, actually typing directly, element. You can go to the L1, then position, it is 2. For example, it is 2. Therefore, it is Hindi. Now, you can go to the right click and then you can go for very small. I am leaving it to you because I don't want to just waste the time in telling all of them. You can come and put it over here. In English, you can put Hindi, you can put it over here like that. What you have to do, you remember that, once again, I repeat, you have to type element, or otherwise you can go to this text box and you can type also element. No need to, if you don't want to type, and this is L1, 3. If you type L1, 3, then the in the list mathematics is in the number 3, therefore it will come automatically. The thing is that the text is being generated by this GeoGebra directly without just waiting for you. Therefore, anyway, I'm just stopping with that. Now, all of you may be interested to put this x-axis, what is there in the x-axis, what is there in the y-axis. Therefore, you can go to this text, and in the x-axis, you are having the subject. Therefore, SUBJECT. Therefore, subject, you can click it, right-click, and then go to the object properties. You can have it as bold, and you can have it as large, and you can have a color for it. I'm just giving a color at random, and then put it in the subject. Is it okay? Okay, now you got, this is subject. Now, marks obtained, we want it, okay? Therefore, we will type marks obtained. Okay, now if I put this marks obtained over here, but I will change the color of it, okay, little bit I will take the text as large and then bold it and then have a beautiful color to it, okay. Now this marks obtained, if I put it, it is not looking nice. This is text 8. There is one more option in GeoGebra. We want it to be rotated. Therefore, go to R-O-T-A-T-E, rotate. It will immediately will ask what is its and rotate the what the object to be rotated. T-E-X-T 8. Text 8. You see it is changing into color. What is the angle you want? All of you know it is 90 degrees. If I rotate it, then it will be nice. For I am going and then putting this 90 degrees. Okay. I got it. Okay. Therefore, okay. Now it has got rotated now. Okay, one minute. I think it's not rotated. Text 9, text 8, okay, then the angle should be 90 degrees. It's already got it now, 90 degrees, okay, I think it has gone down actually somewhere. You check it out, it will be there, okay, it is there, okay, got it, it is there. You see, marks obtained, it has got it, sorry. I think it has gone down somewhere. I think I will delete this. Okay. This marks obtained, once again, you can go to the object properties and then have a text of it. Okay. You can have it large, something you can do. Now, okay. Now, this can be hidden. Therefore, show the object. It can be hidden. Okay. Now, this is the way. Highly interesting. A child can come and check out that actually whatever the idea given to him, he can put it in a bar graph. And in a colorful way, he can do it in a colorful way. He can understand what is a bar chart and what are its entries and how to read it, the data, how to convert it into bar graph, and from the bar graph, how to get the data. Both he can see it. Highly interesting. Thank you. Let us learn to lead.